The first step in starting a new building project is to create a site. In CATIA, this is considered an extended product. An extended product is an AEC-typed assembly that contains other products or parts. Within our site, we're going to insert a typical product and two extended products that are of the type building. Whenever we create new content in CATIA through the insert command, we have the option to pick which type of object we want to insert. Naming is very important. Most offices will have typical naming conventions, and in this case, I'm naming each part with a project number, followed by a scalable naming convention that we can use for the rest of the project. I know that my building is going to contain a base and a tower portion, and I've decided that those two components will be split into separate buildings. Splitting them in this way will allow for more people to collaborate on the project at the same time. Within the physical product, I've inserted a 3D part. This 3D part is going to contain the driver geometry for our project. Now let's insert this site into an existing site that I've already created. I want to do a daylighting analysis on this site. But in order to make that work, I need to make sure that my site has been properly geolocated. When I go to my site planning tab and click on my daylighting analysis tool, you can see that I'm missing my geolocation. So I'll go to Google Maps, find my site location. It's somewhere up there in the upper right-hand corner. There we go. Find the corner. There are my coordinates. So I'll copy these coordinates and paste them into my geolocation dialog box. I'll select my site, activate the geolocation. Now this is tricky. Click on the globe, right click, and paste your coordinates. Now we see the site hasn't been activated, so I'll activate that. I'm not going to paste my coordinates there because they've already been geolocated. And once you geolocate one portion of your project, CATIA is smart enough to compute the geolocation of the rest of your project. Now with my site geolocated, I can simulate the shadows. All of my buildings are selected because I had my 3D shape selected when I ran the command. I don't like the look of that, so I'm going to restart the command without any geometry selected. Back in site planning, cast shadows. From here, I have the option to change the different ambiences, change the time of day, change the time of year, and simulate. You see the options. I can enable shadows. I can show the heliodon. I can show the sun path. I can show or hide the compass. I can also change the scale of the compass if I like. If you want to be sure the shadows are cast correctly or with a high fidelity, change the visual quality. There are a couple ways to get to this menu. One is by right-click display quality. One is through the View tab and your action bar. I selected medium here. The medium quality is going to be relatively good, but if you want to see the shadows cast interactively as you move the sun with your mouse, you need to do high quality. I'm going to make that change here because I want to show how you can simulate the sun, not just at different days of the year, but also at the same time throughout the year. So in this case, we see at 11 a.m., where are the shadows going to be cast throughout the year? This cast shadows command is an intuitive way to observe the different daylighting conditions on your site, and it's great for planning a site strategy.